And then talk to you again about the
first metatarsal pull down by the peroneus longus. There's two peroneals that run down the side of your leg. One goes into your fifth metatarsal base,
yeah,
and one goes into the first metatarsal head and pulls us down.
Okay.
It's for when people walk and they push off. That's the tendon that fires along with the other flexors.
That allows you to do this movement.
What were you talking about?
Exactly.
Tendons?
Yeah, tendons. These are all your muscles and little things that go under all your tendons, okay?
So these tendons here are attached to my tibia, to the posterior?
Yes, to your fibula.
To the fibula. But you were talking about my posterior tibialis, this muscle?
Yeah, posterior tibia. That comes down, goes through here, and has 9 insertions in your foot.
Okay. And so
basically,
what's
that? Arch.
Oh, okay. So basically, stance and grabbing is really the hamstring.
They're all of them. You can't get in that position unless you fire off this muscle, but the more you're able to fire, which is the whole gripping of the floor, you engage all these.
Uh-huh.
Normally, only half of these are stance-based muscles when you stand.
Uh-huh.
But when you're doing this, you get this tension, right?
Yes.
That's when you can feel everything all the way down.
I see. I got a question. I'm always wondering, what's the best way to make a punch? I got to give you a master laser. He does it like this. And I don't forget which one because I do it both ways. One of my students said it's a stronger punch if you make it this way as opposed to this way.
No difference.
There is no difference.
You can even pull them all down together.
Yeah.
As soon as you lock them into this position where these joints are bent over as far as they can and they're locked into this position, and then it just doubles and then it just kind of secures everything else.
But it doesn't really matter then if you fold them in like this.
Nope.
It's just.
All right, I just bring them all together. Because I like this tension where they're all kind of pulling together.
Yeah.
The only time I'd ever do this is when I used to do these blocks.
Well, I would never hang that. I'm just saying that,
right,
that as I make, like say I'm coming in, I'm trying to fold my punch so that I got no air.
As long as they wind up in the same position, doesn't matter.
So,
because you're trying to get this in as tight as you can.
Right.
Because this, if these come in loose, you can never get any strength in there. So these are the most important. The metacarpals coming in and pulling these down into the phalanges.
So basically, when I say I'm doing the Sanchin doubles, and they tell you on the doubles to grab first, I always try to fold, but I really should just do this.
Yes.
Because
this is one tendon that goes into about 4 slips. This has its own individual tendon. So when you engage this, if you engage them all at the same time, you'll get a stronger, instead of trying to do it like this. Because you can pull them all together tightly. If you're trying to do this, I mean, we used to do this for blocks, but it's not as strong as this.
So basically, then, when I'm doing this, I'm better off to this.
Right.
I try to fold them but you're telling me that this is just as effective as
probably
this.
Stronger. Because you're pulling all, you're firing the,
everything at the same
the
time.
Flexor hallucis longus tendons to pull all these together at the same time. If you have to do them individually, you can do that, but it takes longer time and you may not get them all in the same position. Because this is one muscle that goes into 4 slips. So
I'm going to change. I'm definitely going to change.
And you can get more power.
Well, I mean, I tell people that you've got to stay there, and that's the reason why I stay in the graph, you know? But that's what I'm going to change. So here, there, so there.
As this comes down, it basically secures everything else.
This, all at the same time.
And this is how you get it tight. The tighter you can pull this in to begin with,
Yeah.
And then, because if it's like this, you can't get any. You got to bring it all the way down, and then keep kind of pull it down tight.
Yeah. Okay.
And this locks it in.
Yeah.
So you're hitting with this.
Yeah, yeah. See, I always roll because I have a video of Master Wade, a real old video. I got a picture of his hand like this, and I do it both ways, but. I think I used to do it. I used to do it this Master Wagey did it this way.
Right.
Then I had a couple of friends that were doctors. You were doctor?
Yes.
I had a couple of friends, orthopedic surgeon, and he was and a regular practitioner. He was telling me that it's a stronger if you fold this small one in first.
When you engage this muscle, this muscle goes to four slips.
So it does.
So once you engage the muscle. If they pull together, you're working more of the muscle because you're working part of the muscle all the way through here. So if you pull them all together, this muscle gets tight at this point. So they all come together because it comes off one, we call them slips that go into each.
What's this muscle we're talking about? And are these the tendons you're talking about to engage?
Yeah, these are the flexor hallucis.
Okay.
Now these flex the joints, and hallucis just means long. Some of are short and they're stabilized these from side to side, but you're really pulling them in this way because you're not doing anything to go side to side.
So the one muscle branches off into four tendons.
Right. As it goes through the wrist, then it branches.
So that's the tendon here, this is a tendon.
Yes.
This is the tendon.
Yep.
And this is the tendon.
Right.
And here, that's a tendon.
Yes. Yep.
And the thumb has its own.
No, not its own.
So this is best.